On today's show, we're going to be talking about the Aputure Amaran light, which is right. I've been using it to light my background, but now we're going to talk about it. Good morning and welcome to PhotoJoseph's Photo Moment, the first live 3 times a week show here at youtube.com/PhotoJoseph/live. If you're watching it live, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 9:30 a.m. Pacific, talking live about photography, video, live streaming, and all kinds of fun related topics. We do this show regularly live. If you can participate live, it's fantastic because then you get to be part of the chat here. I can bring you up. We can have a conversation. After every main show, we go a secondary show. We do a Q&A where you can ask anything you want about the topic at hand or anything else you'd like, and we try to get all of your questions answered. So if you don't usually get to tune in live, please try to. It's kind of fun. 9:30 a.m. Pacific time, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. This is what we do here. So today we're talking about a light from a company called Aputure, not Aperture, but Aputure, A-P-U-T-U-R-E, called the Amaran light. And this came up because a little while ago, I did a kind of review discussion talk about a smaller light from Aputure. This little tiny guy here, which is, the ALM9. Somebody on the show had pointed this out to me. It's a great little tiny pocket-sized battery-powered rechargeable via USB light with, it's a neat little light. Really liked it. Really was impressed with this thing. And I bought this myself. This wasn't given to me. I wasn't paid to do anything about it. I just really liked it. And the company, the folks at Aputure saw that video and they said, hey, we kind of like that. Do you want to take a look at another one of our lights? And I thought, well, sure, why not? So they have sent this light out to me to do a discussion on, to show you what it can do. And I gotta say, I'm actually pretty impressed with this thing. It's got a lot of pluses, a couple of things we'll talk about that maybe could be a little bit better, but overall I think it's pretty darn cool, pretty darn good. And the first thing I wanna do is talk about what came in the box, because this absolutely impressed the heck out of me. So I get this thing in the box, it comes in a bag like this, and I start opening it up. And honestly, the first time I used it, I took it with me on a trip. I hadn't even taken it out of here yet, and so I'm in the hotel, opening this up going, oh, it's got this and it's got that and it's got this and that, and it was pretty cool. So let me just get this thing off of here. I'm gonna unplug it so it can operate off of the mains, obviously, right? So you can plug that into the wall. I've got a red gel on here because that's how I'm illuminating my background there. But what really impressed me, really surprised me, is everything you're seeing in my hands right now, well, minus the red gel, let's go ahead and get rid of that, came with it. So it came with, so here's the light itself. We'll kind of focus on that in a moment here. But it came with a light stand bendy head thing. What do you call these things? Light stand holder? It's like an umbrella holder, but anyway, it came with this. So it came with this guy, which is great. It came with the light stand post, which is awesome. So this can screw into the light itself, and then you can put this on a light stand or on a tripod head or whatever, and mount your light wherever you want. So it came with all this, which, you know, that's nice, right? It doesn't have to. A lot of times you buy a light or any accessory that's meant to be mounted on something, and you get it and you go, oh, well, now I have to buy the bracket, and I have to buy the post, and I have to buy all these other pieces, but it came with it. Nice. This isn't like the best quality one of these in the world that I've ever seen, but it works, and this isn't exactly heavy, so there you go. So it comes with that. It comes with two different filters. Now the light itself, I will say, can come as a daylight balanced light, which is what I've got here, or you can get it bi-colored. Now when you get a bi-colored light, every other LED is a different color temperature. So you've got daylight and then you've got tungsten, I guess it would be balanced light, I think that's right, orange light. And when you put the light on full daylight, only half the LEDs are lit up, so you only get half of the output. You put it on full tungsten and only half of the lights are on, you get half output. When you put it in the middle, so your color temperature would be somewhere around probably 3,500, 4,000, somewhere around there, that's when you get maximum output, but it's no longer daylight balanced. So I prefer to work with daylight balanced lights. So I got the full daylight one, and then it comes with these gels. So you've got a simple diffuser panel, so that's just gonna, you know, kind of diffuse the light a little bit. You probably wanna use that unless you're bouncing it through another diffusion panel. Or if you want to have that daylight temperature, well, tungsten temperature, here you go. You got a CTO orange on here, you pop this guy in, and now we've got nice warm orange light. So if that's what you want to do, there you go. So it comes with that. So I would highly recommend getting the daylight one only. Also, when you buy it, you do have some other options. Let's take a look over here on the B&H page. So this is the model, it's the Aputure Amaran HR672S. That's the one that I'm using, that's the daylight one. It comes with a couple of different spot degrees. So this is the more focused one, the 25 degree. I forget what the angle is of the other one. It's a much wider view, much wider field. highly recommend going with a focus beam. You can always diffuse your light. It's a lot harder to refocus it. So if you want a softer light, put it in front of a put a diffuser panel in front of it. Yeah, you'll lose some of the output, but you're going to get a good soft diffusion that way. I think going for the spot is definitely the way to go. So the price on this thing, $278, it's not the cheapest, but definitely not the most expensive when it comes to LED panels. You can see on here, you've got some specs on here, the size and weight and all that good stuff. So you know, poke through here if you want to see the thing's 18,000 lux brightness, 45 watt power draw, and so on and so on. So, you know, all the info that you need is in there. So if you want to look at the specs, go poke around in there. I'm not going to go through the specs with you. I want to talk about the light itself. So I take this thing out of the bag. You've got the light. You've got the couple of gels. Cool. Excellent. Find out that I've got the stand and the post. Super. That's really nice. It comes with a little remote control. We'll talk about this in a moment. But you have a little remote control to control this light. Didn't need that. To control this light. And then this blew me away. It comes with not one, but two big, fat Sony-type batteries. Wow. Usually you buy, I've bought $1,000 products that take batteries that don't come with batteries. For a sub-$300 light to come with two of these things, that's pretty cool. So how big are these? These are, have a capacity, 53.28 watt hours. Anyway, they're big. Nice, big, fat batteries. In fact, if you want to know how long these last, our friends over at APN TV did a review. We're going to link to this down below. But they did a battery test on this. I'm not going to give it away. I'm not going to tell you how long they last. I'll let you watch his video to see that. But there, he did a full battery test on it to see just how long they would last. And it's impressive. You will be very pleasantly surprised at how much battery life you get out of these. So it came with the batteries. Super, super surprising. Super happy. It also comes with little extra fuses. So if you blow a fuse on this thing, you got a little extras in there. So that's nice. And all this comes in a nice little bag, that nice little compact bag. Now, one of the cool things about the shape of this, you can see how low profile it is. Other than the dimming knob on here, it's very thin and flat. So you could easily take two of these and sandwich them back to back and have that knob be the only separator, and then put a bunch of these in a case. So you could have quite a lot of these in a relatively small space. And it's not just about the size, it's also about the weight. This is really, really light. And this is where I'm going to say it'd be my first, I'm not sure if I'm really thrilled about that. I love that it's so lightweight, but because it's plastic, you can hear it feels cheap. Now, it isn't a cheap quality light, and I haven't had any issues with it. I haven't, you know, beat the hell out of this thing yet, but I haven't had any issues with it. But I do kind of feel like I wish it was made out of metal. I'm sure that would increase the cost of it. It would certainly increase the weight. I'm sure this is by design, and let's be honest, plastic, modern plastics are really, really strong. They just have that kind of cheaper feel to it. So once you get past that, I think it's just fine. So let's take a look at the back of this thing. Let's go for a little overhead view here. You can see what this thing's got. So these are the two battery slots. So these guys will just slide into there. So let's go ahead and put one in and put two in. And it immediately comes on because I already had the power switch on. You have a dimmer on here. So this little dimmer dial will take you from 99, or that's your maximum, down to 10. Now this is curious because if you look at the website, it says on here that it goes full 0 to 100% dimming. Now, this is the B&H page, not their website, so it's possible that that's incorrect. But there's a disconnect here. So that says 0 to 100. What it actually does, the unit itself does 10 to 99. I mean, 99 is, you know, call it 100, but it doesn't go all the way down to 0. So again, don't know if there's a disconnect here or what, but that's where it goes. The other thing you have on the back of this is a couple of buttons to change your channel and your grouping. Oh, by the way, you also have a battery readout right here. So that's the little battery reader. Channel and grouping on here. This allows you to cycle through, and I realize it's kind of hard. In fact, let's do this. Let me go to a close-up view here. See, I think that'll allow you to see it. Yeah, there you go. As I go through the channels here, it allows me to choose a channel and choose a group for the light. That is for the remote control. Okay, I'm going to turn this, well, I guess down. That is for the remote control. Let me figure out where to put this so you can see that it's changing but not blinding you. Maybe I'll do this. I'm going to take this diffusion panel and pop that in there. That didn't help very much. Let's put the red one on top of it. There we go. Now we're diffusing it. Okay. So you can choose the channel and the group for this little remote control. So let's take a look at the remote control in here. Nice little handy remote control. This allows you to, first of all, you can choose your channel that you want to control. So as I push this, you can see up here these tiny little lights, they just flash. So there's channel 3, channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. So we're on channel 1, I think, is that where I stayed? And then this is the power button. So did I leave this on 1A? I think I did. If I push that, it is, no, I didn't leave it on 1A. Let's see here, let's put this back. Let's put this back. Let's go for the overhead view here, and we're going to go for 1A. So now that's on 1A. There we go. Let's take the intensity down that a little bit and go back into the close-up here. So now I have a power button for 1A. So I hit that. I don't know if you're going to be able to see in here or not. So let's get that into place. I don't know why I'm showing this, like you really don't believe me. That there you go, look, remote control, that works. And then this would change the intensity so we can make it a little bit brighter, a little bit darker on there, or turn it off entirely. So you do have the remote control power with this. You can adjust the intensity, you can turn it on or off. And if you're using one of the lights that is color temperature changeable, the one that has the dual LED colors, then you do have two banks that have a warming and cooling button on there, so you can adjust that. So that's pretty cool. All right, so you've got full control from the little remote. What else about it? It is internally thermally cooled without a fan. It's just got a lot of vents, so it's totally silent. You don't hear it. Okay, it's not even on, but let's do this. I'll turn it back on, and it's totally silent. Oh, I turned it off on the remote. Anyway, nothing. So that's great, right? Because if you're doing any kind of video production, the last thing you want is a fan that either is always on or, even worse, occasionally decides to kick on. You may hear on my live show, occasionally you might hear a fan go on in the background because my computer decides to kick on the fan, maybe the air conditioner decides to kick on. Fans that come and go while you're shooting, no bueno. So a light that does not have any fans in it, super awesome. So that is about it. That's about all there is to say about this thing. It's got all the features you want. It's got a really good brightness value. It has got a really impressive battery life, which again, I'm going to let you watch APN TV's video on that. We'll link to that down below, and it's linked. And overall, I'm digging it. It is a nice, portable, lightweight. Again, lightweight because it's plastic. One hand, I wish it was metal. On the other hand, I'm glad that it's plastic and so lightweight. Goes into a nice little bag, and away you go. So that, my friends, is that. If you decide that you like one of these things, you think you need one for your kit and caboodle, then scroll down below. There's an affiliate link down there. I'd appreciate you use that. Oh, one last thing I wanted to show you on here, almost forgot, is this. So if you look at the bottom of the unit, you got a 1/4-20 thread, but you have one on the side and on the top. No, not on the top, but the other side. So you've got three sides. The bottom and the left and the right side have those. So you can mount it vertically or horizontally landscape if you wanted to. So I like it. Pretty good. All right, folks, that is that. If you want to get a light like this or anything else you see on the show, do me a favor, head over to photojoseph.com/support. We run this show on something we call value for value. If you have gained value from the show, we appreciate you putting value back in. There's lots of different ways you can put value back into the show. One of them, of course, is to buy something that you have seen that you decide you want from my links. That's always helpful. We also have on the new photojoseph.com site the membership. It is a monthly or annual membership that gets you access to live training and a whole bunch of other stuff. That is all linked over there at photojoseph.com/support, so you can check that out there. All right, that, my friends, is everything I want to tell you about this light. So let's jump into the Q&A and see if there's any cues that you have that you want me to A, and I'll do my best to answer your questions.